I laughed at his face multiple times.
Really?
Yeah. But I mean, my favorite thing to do when he used to call me was to put him on speakerphone with, like, on set.
Really?
Like, my whole cast, crew, everybody. And I'd just be like, oh, God, it's calling again. And everybody be like, speaker, 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 speaker. And I'd just put him on speakerphone and leave the room and just let him mumble.
And he would just be rambling about his wheelings and dealings?
Yes.
Is that the kind of vibe? Like, if you're a girl who's spending time with Trump, is that he's just going to constantly try to convince you how important he is?
Yes. Exactly.
Constantly talking about his accomplishments that you don't really care or need to know about.
Exactly.
That's interesting. But so it really was as bad as you described it sexually. It really was just a terrible, extremely short sort of experience.
Pun intended.
Yeah.
Yes.
It was that bad.
It was that bad.
And let me ask you, how many other bad experiences have you had in your life like this bad?
Oh, my gosh. I've had a couple. But they, okay, so the only other two that, like, really stick out in my mind is a scene I did and that me and the guy had, like, no chemistry and he couldn't get it up and it was just terrible and then he tried to blame me for it. But at least I was getting paid for that one.
Yeah, I mean, that's, a bad day on work.
Right, because keep in mind I was not paid for this.
Right, I know.
Like, that's a big misconception.
I know that you hate that people think that.
And then the other really bad one was this guy and he was so cute. And I feel bad for him. Because he was so awkward, but it was almost the same experience, except for whatever reason, he, when he came close to orgasm, like jumped back. And I was like, in my mind, I didn't say this out loud. I'm not that horrible of a person. He was like, I was like, wait, he's coming already? Like, what happened? And he came over my head onto the wall, onto like a really expensive piece of art I had. And then he fell off the bed and knocked a candle off and set my room on fire.
How on fire?
The curtain went up and luckily, like, I yanked the curtain down and stomped on it. But I lost my security deposit on the apartment because when I stomped on it, it the carpet was charred.
What a nut. That's amazing.
It was quite a nut. Yes, it was.
So you're telling me that this guy was having sex with you and then he got really far away because he perhaps knew the force of his own nut and he knew that he had to get a ways away because he didn't want to injure you.
That could be it.
But then it destroyed a Picasso.
It was not a Picasso.
Okay, but something comparable. I would like to imagine it's something like millions of dollars.
No. Okay. But yeah, that happened.
Wow. That's incredible.
But at least he was like really kind of young and cute. I mean, I was young too. This was like a long time ago.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I guess that's kind of the question. Like, how many, if as a woman, if you've gone to your point in life, have you had a lot of run-ins with micropenis?
Oh, you know what? You want to hear something crazy? Not really, because most of the sex I've had has been in movies, so I know what I'm getting into. I've never had a one-night stand.
Really?
Yeah.
That's interesting. But what, like, the Trump thing could have turned into a one-night stand, right?
This is actually a debate that I have with my friends, because people are like, yes, you did, because it was with Trump. But so what defines a one-night stand? Is it somebody that you only have sex with once and never speak to again? Or does it count if you only have sex once but you still talk? See, I only had sex with him once, but we talked 100 more times, and I saw him 2 more times. There was just nothing sexual. So is that a one-night stand, or is the actual definition of a one-night stand is you, like, never talk to the person again?
I don't know. That's like a good question.
Yeah, so...
Because I feel like, especially in my old age, that you sort of like, it almost seems kind of sick to just have sex with somebody one time and not keep talking to them after.
But people do that all the time.
Yeah, but just
I don't,
as an adult, it just wouldn't feel right. It would feel so strange to never text them again. But I've also been in a relationship for like 3.5 years, so I'm like kind of slowly forgetting what it would be like to actually be single.
Yeah.
So you spent a large percentage of your life in relationships?
Yeah.
You're that kind of person.
Yeah.
And let me ask you, does it always get fucked up because of the porn?
No.
You haven't had that experience.
I have, but no, actually my last relationship, it wasn't even a thing. And I think that's what one of the things I liked about it so much.
He never mentioned it?
But he would mention it, like, but not in that context. It's not like he was in denial, but he's the only person that I've ever been with that it wasn't a thing either way. It wasn't like cool, like I'm digging fucking Stormy Daniels, like, eh. Or like want to meet my porn star friend. Like, it was never like cool.
He just didn't care.
And it never was a thing. Like, I never felt like he was with Stormy Daniels.
Really?
Yeah, it was awesome.
Is that like a...
Turns out he was fucking crazy, but oh, really? That wasn't a thing.
Crazy how?
Just
he shot you? He shot at you?
No, but he would have if he had a gun, I'm sure.
Really?
Yeah.
That's scary.
He had a bad temper.
Damn.
And he's crazy.
You gotta be careful for that.
But the porn thing wasn't the thing. And then the guy I was with before him, that was probably our biggest issue. And the funny thing is, he did porn with me.
Really? But then he just couldn't keep it going?
Yeah, it got to where he just couldn't handle it and would like wanted me to quit. I mean, it was bad.
He would know you were at work and he would just be thinking about some other guy just dragging makeup off your face with his wiener and
pretty much
couldn't handle that.
And then when I would come home, he was just a dick for like a week.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
And then he was, you know, and he was mean to all my friends that were in the business. And I have a really close friend named Michael Vegas, who's one of the nicest people you've ever met. Uh-huh. And my ex would be like, would just talk mad shit about him.
Really?
Hated him. And if you hate Michael Vegas, there's something wrong with your soul.
Okay. Yeah, because, like, okay, I know a girl who is a huge famous porn star, and she, like, went on vacation with her boyfriend for a month. The boyfriend had always been cool about her getting gangbanged, all this shit on camera, but then they come back from the vacation, and he just gets real with her, and he just tells her, like, yo, like, I realized this month that I don't want you getting gangbangs anymore.
Well, that just sounds like his feelings grew.
Right. But he realized, I think, in that time, like, oh, I'm happier when I don't have to think about the fact that my girlfriend is gangbang. But gangbang. But then she just literally was like, I'm sorry. Like, this is a part of me. Like, this is more important than you, which I respect so much.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah,
it's like if a girl told me that she wanted me to stop fucking doing cartwheels or doing podcasts or whatever, you know?
Yeah. So I have a friend that had the opposite kind of thing happen.
Really?
Yeah. So she knew this guy for a long time, casually dated, but they weren't serious. He had like somebody he was more interested in, and she was had somebody she was more interested in. And then finally they got together to go on like a real date. Mm. And he came back to her house and was like, so I started talking about how he wanted to like call a friend over so they could do, and she was like, whoa, I don't even, and he's like, yeah, but you like anal. And she was like, I've done two anal scenes. I'm not really that kind of girl. And he kind of was like, I want to see this. Like, and she was the one that was like, I'm the most vanilla person in my personal life you could ever imagine. Like, for me, it's not like that. And he was like, I spent like all these years like waiting and like planning to finally, like, and you're going to take this from me? And she was like, what the fuck are you talking?
So he just assumed that she was going to be down for every wild ass thing. Wow.
Yeah. And she was like, she's like, I'm not even that crazy on camera, but like my personal life, I'm like the most like vanilla you could ever imagine.
I mean, you can't be presumptuous and assume that just because she does something on camera that she's going to want to get into that.
Yeah. But it was like the opposite. It's the guy like saying like, hey, let's do it.
I'm going to the porn convention in Vegas. Uh-huh. And it's funny because this is my second time going. But the last time I went, I remember thinking like, oh, this is going to be a fuck fest. Like everybody's going to be banging. There's going to be girls just talking about threesomes everywhere you go. Really not like that, because that's when the girls are working the hardest. They're literally standing up like 10 hours a day taking pictures with sweaty ass dudes.
No shit. At least when we're on set, we get to lay down.
Yeah. And then you
bend over. I mean, like,
if the girls don't go out and you see them by like midnight, they already got their makeup off and they're in sweats and shit because they're all tired, you know? Because they're normal work days. Maybe kind of intense, but it's not so long.
Yeah. And it's just different. You don't have to be as. I think a lot of it comes from the mental, like, wear of you get tired, like, with so many people and you don't know who's coming up behind you. And that's where it's that. You're tense. When you're on set, you're among friends and you're hanging out and, you know.
Do you feel like, because I feel this way, to be totally honest, like when you just are meeting, like you do a meet and greet and you got to meet 100 people or never mind more than that, that there's an extent to which it's kind of like having to meet that many people is sort of like robbing you of like.
Your soul.
Of energy that you have.
Yes.
It's very hard to have that sort of superficial level meeting over and over without it somehow fucking up the part of your brain that is actually trying to have like real communication or real interactions with people.
Yeah. And it's a lot of the people are totally cool and respectful and it goes pretty quick, but there's always like that one or two people that are just like. And then there's, my tour manager is sitting over there, Dwayne. He's worked for me for like 11 years. And so there is an actual thing. He can back me up. Dwayne, last guy, last night, last show, always, right? Yeah. It's without fail.
The last guy in the
line. After the last show on the last night, whether I'm there for a week or one night and like But if I'm there like a Thursday, Friday, Saturday, whatever, it's always the last guy standing in line at the end of the Saturday night that's just going to be a fuck.
In an awkward, weird, creepy way, or in like a weird, aggressive way?
It's always the worst experience of the entire thing. And sometimes they're just like weird, like they're nice, but they're weird. Or it's like some guys or it's the guy that bites me. I'm not making that up. Or it's the one who like,
what part of your body did he bite?
I've been bit in the face. I've been bit on the ass. I had a guy once. Dwayne wasn't with me for this one, but like one of the weirdest things that ever happened was a guy came up to get a picture and I went to put my arm around him like this and he just dropped and licked my armpit. It was and then took off running.
Oh my God. These dudes are undefeated, man.
I was just like, I felt so violated. It was so strange. It was so strange.
This, but the porn fans, like, it's just certain dudes who, you know, they're just trying to eke out some tiny little bit of what they want from you. Like, they know, you know that, like, really they want to have sex with you, but if they can't get that, I'm just going to lick an armpit.
Right?
Just, that's so weird. I can at least do that.
It's not the grossest thing I've had happen, but it was, you know.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
You don't want to know.
Really? I really don't want to know?
No.
I'm thinking I want to know.
Do you want to know?
I want to know.
Dwayne's like, you don't want to know. Everybody, I'm Stormy Daniels. Thanks for watching. If you liked what you saw, make sure to leave a comment. And if you didn't like what you saw, I really don't give a fuck. Make sure to follow us at No Jumper and the Stormy Daniels.